Welcome to Wind Info. Today we gonna know about velvet worms. Onychophora, from ancient Greek onychos, claws and pherion, to carry, commonly known as velvet worms due to their velvety texture and somewhat worm-like appearance, or more ambiguously as Peripatus perps, after the first described genus, Peripatus, is a phylum of elongate, soft-bodied, many-legged panarthropods. In appearance they have variously been compared to worms with legs, caterpillars, and slugs. They prey upon smaller animals such as insects, which they catch by squirting an adhesive slime. Approximately 200 species of velvet worms have been described, although the true number of species is likely greater. The two extant families of velvet worms are Peripatidae and Peripatopsidae. They show a peculiar distribution, with the peripatids being predominantly equatorial and tropical, while the peripatopsids are all found south of the equator. It is the only phylum within Animalia that is wholly endemic to terrestrial environments. Velvet worms are generally considered close relatives of the Arthropoda and Tardigrada, with which they form the proposed taxon Panarthropoda. This makes them of paleontological interest, as they can help reconstruct the ancestral arthropod. In modern zoology, they are particularly renowned for the curious mating behavior and for bearing live young. Velvet worms are segmented animals with a flattened cylindrical body cross-section and rows of unstructured body appendages known as oncopods or lobopods, informally, stub feet. The animals grow to between 0.5 and 20 centimeters, 0.2 to 8 in, with the average being about 5 centimeters, 2 in, and have between 13 and 43 pairs of legs. The skin consists of numerous, fine transverse rings and is often inconspicuously colored orange, red or brown, but sometimes also bright green, blue, gold or white, and occasionally patterned with other colors. What is the velvet worm known for? Velvet worms are ambush predators, hunting other small invertebrates by night. To subdue their prey, they squirt a sticky, quick-hardening slime from a pair of glands on their heads. After the prey is ensnared, the velvet worm bites into it, injecting digestive saliva that helps liquefy the insides for easier snacking. A velvet worm's venomous. Velvet worms secrete saliva that has the ability to immobilize their prey. The saliva is very effective against insects but does not have any effect on humans. Their bites can cause pain but are not poisonous. Do velvet worms make good pets? Velvet worms are careful about going after prey, because it takes a lot of energy and calories to produce the glue they use for hunting. Remember, there are several different species of velvet worm, so feel free to check them all out. Some come in rather beautiful colors and can be a really cool pet to care for. Do velvet worms have eyes? Unlike arthropods, velvet worms do not have an exoskeleton, hence their limbs have no need for joints to facilitate mobility. On the head is a pair of sensory antennae, and small eyes. How does the velvet worm catch its prey? Velvet worms capture their prey by squirting sticky slime from their oral tubes. The slime effectively entangles the prey so it can't escape. The velvet worm bites off parts of the prey then sucks them up after they have been softened by digestive saliva extruded from the velvet worm's mouth. How far can velvet worms shoot slime? 2 feet over millennia, these ancient creatures have evolved a pair of hunting weapons unlike any other in nature, dual high-speed cannons capable of jetting viscous slime onto their prey from up to 2 feet away. Delivered with such power and speed, the velvet worm's slime cannon takes the element of surprise to new levels. What is the garden hose instability and how does it relate to the velvet worm? These opposing forces push each other harder and harder, and soon, the tube is flexing back and forth, like an untended garden hose writhing when the faucet is wide open. Physicists call this behavior an elastic instability, and it causes the velvet worm's slime tubes to oscillate up to 60 times per second. How did velvet worm evolve? DNA evidence suggests velvet worms are closely related to crabs and spiders, possibly as a very early member of the group that gave rise to both. But fossil analysis seems to push the worm's origins much farther back, relating it to a lookalike in 540 million year old rocks. Thanks for watching. Let's meet in next video with interesting facts and information.